Hi, I'm Mike, PokeTips Mike, and we're all about to start our adventure in the world of Pokemon Sword and Shield. So today, I want to share with you three huge tips that'll help you immensely when you start your journey in the Galar region. Once you're done watching this video, you'll know how to get plenty of rare Pokemon and much more before you even turn on the game. So, are you ready to start like a pro? Then let's jump right into tip number one, prepare yourself with special event Pokemon. As soon as Sword and Shield come out, if you know what you're doing, you'll be able to get four special event Pokemon right away. These Pokemon include the mythical Pokemon Mew, Gigantamax Pikachu, Gigantamax Eevee, and of course, Gigantamax Meowth the Long Cat. Obtaining Mew in-game is going to be basically the same way it was in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. You'll need to have a brand new Pokeball Plus accessory, and if you do have one of those, it'll be very easy to get Mew. All you'll need to do is go to the mystery gift option in-game, connect to your Pokeball Plus, and then you'll be able to download the Mew into your game. Very simple, very easy, and it would be epic to start your adventure in Sword and Shield with a Mew, because I believe you could get this Pokemon pretty early. But here's a very important thing to note. If you already redeemed the Mew from the Pokeball Plus in Let's Go Pikachu or Let's Go Eevee, you won't be able to redeem it in Sword and Shield and get another Mew. If this is you and you're not in a rush, I would just recommend wait until 2020 when Pokemon Home comes out and just transfer your Mew over from Let's Go into Sword and Shield instead of buying a whole new Pokeball Plus. Now, getting Gigantamax Pikachu and Eevee are going to be very simple as long as you already have Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee. If you have save data for Let's Go Pikachu or Let's Go Eevee on your Switch, once you get to the Wild Area Station in your game, which apparently is going to take about 2 hours of gameplay according to the Pokemon website, you'll be able to obtain the special Pikachu if you have Let's Go Pikachu and the special Eevee if you have Let's Go Eevee. And like I mentioned before, both of these are going to be able to Gigantamax into their crazy new forms. Also, if you were wondering, it's been confirmed on the Pokemon website that the special Pikachu and special Eevee will not be able to evolve. Now, unlike Mew, the special Pikachu and special Eevee, this Meowth is going to be available to everybody. All you'll have to do is go on the mystery gift feature and download Meowth to your game, and I think you have up until like early January to go ahead and do that. So if you're prepared and have all this stuff available to you, you can potentially get four special event Pokemon on the first day of Pokemon Sword and Shield's release. Pro tip number two, know your exclusives. So Pokemon games have always had version exclusives, dating all the way back to the original games Pokemon Red and Blue. Since catching, training, and interacting with your Pokemon is one of the most important things in Pokemon, you'll definitely want to know what the version exclusives are, so you can get your favorites in your game. As of right now, we know about a lot of the different version exclusives in Sword and Shield. Now, Pokemon Sword version has all the exclusives that I can't pronounce, so bear with me here. There's Dino, Svilus, and Hydreigon, the pseudo-legendaries from the Generation 5 games Pokemon Black and White, Jangmoo, Hakamoo, and Kamoo from Pokemon Sun and Moon, Gothita, Gothorita, Gothitelle, Turtonator, Farfetch'd, and its new evolution Sirfetch'd, and of course, the legendary Pokemon on the box, Zacian. Now for the Pokemon Shield exclusives, there's Larvitar, Pupitar, and Tyranitar, the pseudo-legendaries from Generation 2, Goomy, Sligo, and Goodra, the pseudo-legendaries from Generation 6, Solosis, Duosion, Reuniclus, Vullaby, Mandibuzz, Drampa, Galarian Ponyta, the speculated Galarian Rapidash, and Zamazenta. As of right now, those are all the version exclusives that we know about. Once Sword and Shield come out, I'll make a video updated with all of the version exclusives so you can know exactly what you could find in each game. When I put that video out, there will be a link to it in the description. Obviously, you'll be able to trade and obtain the exclusives for the other game, but if you want to go through your playthrough using Galar, Ponyta, and Tyranitar, it'll be a lot easier for you if you just get the Shield version. Likewise, if you want to use Farfetch'd and its new evolution Sirfetch'd, you'd be better off picking up Pokemon Sword. Whichever game you choose, knowing the exclusive Pokemon for your game is definitely going to help you out in the future. And last but not least, pro tip number three is start the game with some sort of pre-order or early purchase bonus. So a lot of stores like GameStop, Walmart, or even Amazon give you a little something extra if you order Pokemon Sword and Shield early. Now, I'll have a link in the description to Pokemon.com's official list of pre-order bonuses, but the main one I'm going to talk about in this video is the early purchase bonus that you get for downloading Pokemon Sword and Shield on the Nintendo eShop. Now, this bonus runs all the way until January 15th, 2020, so if you're watching this early, you have some time to get this reward. Basically, all you gotta do is buy the game from the Nintendo eShop, and then after that, Nintendo will email you a code that'll give you 12 Quick Balls to use in your adventure. Now, if you know anything about Quick Balls, you'll realize these are extremely useful, especially early on in the game. If you use a Quick Ball in the very first turn of the battle, it has a 5x catch rate multiplier. That makes it more than twice as good as using an Ultra Ball. If you have those 12 Quick Balls early on in your adventure, you'll be able to basically catch anything you want with very little effort. Now, the only thing that makes this reward kind of lackluster is eventually at some point in the game, you're more than likely going to be able to buy lots and lots of Quick Balls. So this pre-order bonus only is really the most useful when you first start off the game, which is why it fits pretty well into this video, because it'll absolutely give you a huge advantage when you first start the game. However, if you want something more long-lasting, I'd recommend pre-ordering the game from somewhere else. Alright, and with that, my friends, that's gonna wrap up my list of tips that'll help you start like a pro in Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield. If you use this information in this video, you'll be so far ahead of people that don't know this stuff, and you'll absolutely be ready to take on the Galar region like a pro. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you're new for more Pokemon content just like this, follow me on Instagram at PokeTipsMike, and my friends, I'll be seeing you in the next one.